Hi viewers, welcome to LMS Solution. Today we are going to see about harmonic mitigation in a grid connected PV system using Shunt Active Power Filter. So this is a simulation model we developed for harmonic mitigation in a grid connected PV system using Shunt Active Power Filter. So this model consists of PV array. The PV array is going to be connected to the inverter via this boost converter. So this inverter is going to be connected to the point of common coupling, so via this LCL filter. And then here we have that grid, and here we have Shunt Active Power Filter. So here we have nonlinear load. So the PV array rating is 100.2 kilowatts. So here we are using 47 parallel string. So each string having 10 series connected model. So single panel maximum power will be 213.115 watts, and voltage at maximum power point is 29 volt. So this is IV PV characteristics of the considered PV array. And it will be connected to the inverter via this boost converter. That boost converter going to be controlled by means of P into MPPT. So MPPT receiving two inputs, one is PV voltage, another one is PV current, and output will be reference voltage. So that reference voltage will be compared with the PV voltage and process via PA controller and compared with the sawtooth waveform, and finally we'll get the PWM pulse. So this pulse is going to be controlled this IGBT to extract the maximum power from the PV array, as well as boost the voltage from 290 volt to 700 volt. 700 volt nothing but a DC-link voltage of the inverter. So this inverter, three phase inverter, going to be controlled by means of voltage and current controller. And current controller, here we are using feed forward decoupling control concept. So for that we have to use PLL. So this is a PLL. So PLL is going to be generate omega t, and then we are converting grid voltage and inverter current to DQ0 format by using power transmission. So here we have VD VQ and ID IQ of the three phase inverter of the PV side, and here we are measuring the DC link voltage and going to be compared with the reference voltage, and it going to be processed via PA controller. So this controller going to be generate the reference current in the form of ID reference. So this ID reference going to be compared with the ID actual of the PV inverter. And here the IQ reference is 0 because we are sending only real power to the point of common coupling via this inverter from this PV source. Okay. And so the IQ reference going to be compared with the IQ, actual IQ of that PV inverter, and it going to be, that mean the error current, right? So this error current going to be processed via this PA controller, and then this two PA controller will be generated the control signal, and this portion known as feed forward decoupling control concept. Okay, so here we are applying that feed forward decoupling control concept, and finally we will get this control signal in the form of a D and Q. Again we have to convert the D and Q into ABC form by using inverse power transformation. So here we will get a three phase controlled voltage. So this three phase controlled voltage going to be compared with the triangular wave for generating the pulse for the inverter, three phase inverter. See, this pulse going to be control this inverter to maintain the DC link at 700 volt DC link voltage, and whatever power we are generating from PV array, so that going to be via that three phase inverter to that point of common coupling. And here we have grid voltage is 400, and frequency is 50 hertz. And here we are using nonlinear load, that means diode rectifier with RL load. And here we have shunt active power filter. So this is a DC link capacitor for shunt active power filter, and it consists of three phase inverter, coupling inductor, voltage controller, and then compensating current calculation by using PQ control theory. And then here you have hysteresis control as well as PWM control. Okay, so here we have to measure the DC link voltage. So the DC link voltage is going to be compared with reference voltage 700 volt, and it is going to be processed via PA controller. That PA controller will be generate the power loss component, okay, for that PQ control theory. And then here we have to use grid voltage and the load current for generating the compensating current, okay, for that is shunt active power filter. So here we are using PQ control concept. So by using grid voltage and load voltage, so we have to calculate alpha beta zero voltage and alpha beta zero current. So based upon that we have to calculate PQ and P naught. Okay, and then after calculation of this PQ, P naught and I naught, so next you have to calculate that mean you have to calculate difference of average power and actual real power. So the final power will be going to be subtracted with the power loss component, and finally we will get the real power requirement. So based upon this real power requirement, reactive power requirement, and then P naught, I naught, and then grid voltage, right? So here we are applying the inverse PQ control theory concept. So here you have to calculate alpha beta zero component of the voltage. So here you have to calculate alpha beta zero component of the current, and based upon that here we are going to calculate the compensating current for that shunt active power filter. So next process after generating that reference current, right? So that reference current will be compared with the shunt active power filter current. Okay, so the difference between the reference current and the shunt active power filter current, then it can be processed by hysteresis controller. If you want to use hysteresis control, you can use hysteresis control. So here we are using PWM generator. So the difference of that reference current and actual current going to be processed by PWM generator. So it going to be generate the pulse for that three phase inverter of the shunt active power filter. Okay, so it going to be control this three phase inverter, so for injecting the compensation current now to mitigate the harmonic in the grid current. Okay, so this is operation of that grid connected PV system with this inductive power filter for harmonic mitigation. Now I am going to explain the simulation by not considering the nonlinear load and the shunt active power filter, that being PV generating power and sent to the grid, and you have to check the THD of the grid current. Okay, and then after that you have to include nonlinear load, and then you have to check the THD of the grid current, and finally you have to add shunt active power filter, and then you have to check the THD of the grid current. So you have to see the difference of THD of the grid current for a different mode of operation. Okay, so now we are not considering the nonlinear load and the shunt active power filter. So this is a result of PV power, grid voltage, grid current, and the DC link voltage of the inverter. Okay, so after completion of simulation we have to check the THD of the grid current. Okay, so for that go to workspace and click this one out, and then here you can click scope data 2 and then track here, because the grid current component stored in the scope data 2. After that go to simulation and go to power GI and tools FFT analysis and click input 2, and then click CMS maximum frequency and click display. So here you can see that when the grid is sending power to the grid, okay, now we are not considering any nonlinear load in the system. So we are getting almost 3.63% DHT. That means it's less than 5% only. Okay, that means it follow that IEEE standard. Okay. Now I'm going to include that nonlinear load in the system. Okay, at the point of common coupling. Okay, so this nonlinear load I'm going to add it here. Now I'm going to simulate the system, and then you have to check the result. So we will get the same PV power, grid voltage and DC voltage, but there is some changes in the grid current. That mean there will be some distortion in the grid current, because now we are added that nonlinear load, right? Because of nonlinear load, what happened, right? It draws the reactive power from the grid. So because of that, that mean reactive power as well as the nature of the grid current will be non-sinusoidal. Okay, so now we are going to check the THT of the grid current after adding that nonlinear load. And I'm going to refresh this one and click input 2 and then check the THT. Now you can see the THT, right? So THT is around 7.23. Okay, so it more than 5% is not obey the IEEE standard. Okay, so now I'm going to add that Shunt Active Power Filter in the point of common coupling. Okay, so now I added the Shunt Active Power Filter in the common coupling, point of common coupling, and then I'm going to simulate the result. And then here you have to check the grid current quality, whether after adding that Shunt Active Power Filter, whether THD go down less than, that mean is goes down to less than 5% or it remained at 7.63% or not, right? We have to check that one, right? So now we added that to the inductive power filter and the point of common coupling in order to mitigate the harmonics in the grid current, right? So you have to check the result. So after checking the result only we can justify the result. Okay, so after completion of this simulation we will go to check the result of the grid current THT. So again I am going to check the THT of the grid current with the Shunt Active Power Filter. So now we can see that the THT is comes down to 4.85%, right? So now the THT is 4.85% is less than 5% only. So after adding Shunt Active Power Filter, so that as Shunt Active Power Filter mitigate the harmonic effect in the grid current, that means it eliminate that harmonic component in the grid side current, right? So the Shunt Active Power Filter will be eliminate the harmonic effect in the grid current. So this is working of that harmonic mitigation in the grid connect PV system using Shunt Active Power Filter. Thanks for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for notification about upcoming videos. Thank you. Thank you so much. Bye bye.